they gathering for the big arrival? Oh! They're giving a speech. I'm guessing everyone's over there. Except for the Cant Master, but I don't need pet food. Well, the time is here. The world's fate, not just ambush, is riding on this battle. King Alpha's going to speak. Oh, they just say the same thing. Scared? I'm just here to defend my country where I was born and raised. Galga's destructive activities will stop here at Bolt. Magisa says, King Alfred is now going to brief us on our strategy. Yurio says, we should listen. Come on, let's go. But I want to talk to the other guy. Oh, Morrison? Okay. Everyone listen to my words. I will explain our operation strategy for defending against Galga. Alfred says, this is probably the largest and most dangerous operation in the history of Ambush. But I believe we can succeed. Listen very carefully. Galga attack plan phase 1. Once Galga approaches Bolt, we will light up the fishing fires to lure it and control its path. They're already lit. Gweld's prophecy tells to make a path of lights and show it the way. I wonder if it's going to work. If we interpret it correctly, we can avoid direct damage to Bolt. Attack plan phase 2. After leading Galga to the East Valley, with Can Master Magisa's help, it will shut off its escape route. Attack plan phase 3. After trapping Galga in the valley, we will restrict its movement with nets and attack all out. That is all. Galga is on its way here. I pray for our success. Commence operations. Cheers. Sounds ominous indeed. Hey! Alfred says. You two stay here. Your Majesty, Galga has started to move. He's coming. Good work. Go back to your post. Yes, sir. Morrison, Magisa, please get ready. Yes, Your Majesty. We'll do our best, Magisa says. Okay, and we're supposed to hide. Lodi says, I can fight. Let's go fight together. I guess there's no way you'd listen. I know you're asking me to stay, but I want to end matters with Galga, with my own hands. I understand, but let me say this. Don't throw your own life away. Okay. You two wait here. Understand?
I don't want to wait.
Chris says, we can't just sit here and wait. Yurio says, but... No buts. We're going. Yeah. Well, I guess we can't go back. Or can we? Well, I don't think we're going to find anyone over there, so let's go. Oh. Well, what did you find up here? A remind potion. Thank you. I think it's a good idea to save right now. I don't care about your bad mood. Galga's coming. Crap. It doesn't look like he was going to come up from the sea. Huh. Good work. Guide Galga to the valley. Okay, Galga spelled wrong. Man, Galga isn't moving for some reason. We were able to guide Galga to the beach. Let's swim out to Galga and punch it in the eye. Is there anyone up there? Oh, there is somebody up there. Who is that? Is that Alfred? Galga is right nearby, but he won't come ashore for some reason. Alfred said he is responding to the torches, right? Yes, there is no mistake about that. Maybe he figured out our plans? Go ahead as planned. We're no match against him in the water. Yes, sir. Should we talk to some other people? Who is this? Oh, it's Lodi. Galga. The monster that sunk my father into the sea and ruined my village. This valley will be the last thing you see. Huh? Hey, what are you doing here? Chris says, well, don't try too hard. Yo-Yo says, yeah, we still need to learn about swords from you. Thanks. I'll be okay. You guys just watch me fight from a safe place, okay? Don't do anything dangerous. Morrison says, please don't interrupt Majisa. She is a deciding factor of this operation. Oh, well, I was trying to interrupt her anyway. Be quiet. Right now, Majisa is trying to convert her spirit into a large magical spell. Please don't ruin her concentration. Anyone else up here? Oh. Thank you. I'll always take a good remind potion. That's a dead end. I know we have to talk to Alfred, but I wonder what the other soldiers are going to say. You don't see us. Well, these are the two I talked to. We have to guide Galga to the valley. If he gets away from here, we're in big trouble. It's exciting. There's nothing that way. Anyone else around here? We can't do anything unless Galga enters the valley. Right? Unless you want Galga in here, I'm guessing. I guess that I'm guessing. So we're talking about a dead end. Alright, let's go talk to Alfred. Hi! Yo-Yo, Chris, go back to the city of Bolt. But, Yo-Yo says, Chris says we have to hurry and guide Galga ashore. Yo-Yo says he doesn't want to come, right? Yeah, but... Chris says, I have an idea. What's that? We're going to guide Galga with food. That's a great idea, Yo-Yo says. Chris, you're so smart. So what are we going to use as bait? Yo-Yo. Huh? Yo-Yo is going to be the bait. Alfred says, wait a minute, that's a little too much. Why me? We have to bait Galga into the valley. That's the only way to go ahead as planned. All the world's fate is depending on this. Yo-Yo says, but, don't worry. We're too small for Galga to seriously come after us. You're probably swallowed by Galga in the water, but on the shore, you'll be able to run. You're so good at running. I don't think that's the issue here. Chris says, understand? Just go to the shore and scream your head off. Galga will eventually start to move. Yurio, are you ready? No. I don't wanna. This is too much. I can't do it. What are you saying? Chris says. We need Galga to get into the valley to continue as planned. I'm not saying you have to fight with Galga. Just run. That's all you have to do. Man, you have no choice. This is a good time to get rid of your reputation as a crybaby. Yurio, it's up to you. We're all depending on you. Good luck. You make it sound so easy. Let me ask one thing. The valley's not a dead end, is it? It is, actually. Alpha says, no, don't worry about that. Galga is too big to get through, but humans can. If anything, we want to move to that little area right off the very end, that small area. That makes me feel a little better. Just a little, though. Oh boy. Lodi's voice says, Yurio! What are you doing? Come back! Chris's voice says, don't say that! You're Galga's bait! Do your best! Bait? Lodi says. Is Chris really a child of the chapel? Alf says, if it gets too dangerous, be sure to run. Chris says, get closer. Move around so that you look delicious. Man, I can't believe this. I hope it's another tough running thing like we did to get through the freaking Dada Fortress. Galga! Over here! Well, if you don't want to come, you don't have to. Call to Galga louder, Chris says. Man, Chris, you dork. Why don't you come here and do it yourself, then? Yurio! Did I do something wrong? You turned your back on Galga, that's what you did. Hello? Lodi says, now is not the time for pleasantries. Run, Chris says. I'm not running, he is. Oh my god, he's like hopping. Yeah, I was hoping this wasn't like a running skill thing. Oh, he jumps up. Good work. You're a brave man, worthy of knighthood, soldier says. Wow, Yurio, you lured Galga, Chris says. Whew, man, I wouldn't want to go through that again. Alfred says, commence phase two! Medusa! Whoa. Oh, wow. A wall? Oh, did she lock him behind the wall? Is he to the south? Quelled. Thanks for your help, Medusa says. Oh! Good work, Medusa, says Alfred. Commence phase three! Yes, sir! Oh, wow. Here comes Lodi. We did it, Yurio. You're not a crybaby anymore. Yeah! You two wait here. It's dangerous. I'll finish this off. I can't believe we're actually going to get rid of Galga. It's too easy. We must defeat Galga! Oh! What? What was that? Lodi says. Retreat! They got repelled somehow. Is Galga a magic user? Your Majesty, Galga is using strange powers. Medusa says, I feel from inside Galga. I feel an evil consciousness inside Galga, different from Galga's consciousness. Morrison says, Galga must be controlled by someone else. Lodi, Alfred says, we're backing you up. Not thinking it through. Yurio says, Chris, I'm going. What? I can't just sit here and watch Lodi and Al fight. Alright, Chris, you better follow them. Me too! If we get any closer, I guess we get blown away, Lodi says. Lodi took out something round wrapped in cloth from inside his clothes. Ah, what do you have there, Lodi? Inside the cloth was a ball of a crimson fire, much bigger than what Yurio and Chris saw at Negar Island. It's the pure crimson fire, Yurio says. Lodi says it was worth it to bring this dangerous thing from so far away. Galga, it's payback time. Well, that got through. Got some blistering gums there. What the hell is this? What? Alfred says, that's the monster that was controlling Galga. Yurio says, Lodi, we're going to fight too. Lodi says, it's not an easy job. I'm counting on you. The four formed a team to defeat the parasitic monster. Can we save? We got some kind of boss battle here. Oh my, so exciting. Okay. It's Galga, or whatever this thing is. Time. Alright, so... Now... Alfred's equipment. So he's got the steel spear and the ring mail. Let's give him a power ring plus one. And I'm assuming Lodi has all the things he had on him. Just gonna check. Okay. Have at thee. Bazira Bazimian? Here you go. That should help, although those things... Those other things took zero. They look like jellyfish or something? What is this? A Bazimian, Baziminian, Bazminion, and then Bazara. So what should we do? Get rid of the minions first? Let's do a finishing move on the Bazara, actually, then. And let's do Cheer. Alfred will attack this Baziminion. And Lodi will attack the other Baziminion. Water ball. Another water ball. Not so tough, not so tough. Show you what I've got. .235 on that thing. Okay, Yurio will now attack that one. She can reach the Bezerra with the Wind Cutter. We'll do that. Alfred will also attack the Baziminion. And Lodi will do his finishing move on the Bezerra. This thing is still kicking. Oh, it... Oh, that was that Wind Cutter. Never mind. She's also doing Wind Cutter? Yeah, that's her Wind Cutter. I thought it deflected her Wind Cutter back at him or something. Pretty good. Okay. We need some healing going on. They're both at exactly 45. I'm not sure who to heal. Thank you. Let's heal, Lodi. He's closer. I don't think she needs to run up to him to heal him, but yeah, let's heal him. He doesn't know spells. What about skills? Whirlwind? Oh, the Baza minion's there too. Right. Let's try to finish off this thing. Well, Baza minion anyway. I want to finish off one of them. This could be a problem. Oh boy. Yeah, heal him already. Don't go for Lodi. Okay. Okay, we got rid of one of those Baza minion things. Okay, now Chris will heal. Alf. Oh, she can't reach him. Oh no. I guess heal Uriel. Looks like he's the one being attacked. And he has the least points out of people that she can reach. Alfred, I guess we'll just use a cure potion. I hardly ever use these things, so might as well. And then Lodi. Lodi will attack the Bazaar, I suppose. Cure potion! I think they give him back a lot. This thing is doing a wing cutter again. Oh! Well, good thing he took that potion. I think she heals for more than the potion. I want to use her finishing move, but we need to heal. Let's do... And she's getting low on magic, too. Let's... Ah, oh, she can't reach him. That's right. Alright, might as well use her finishing move, then. On the Bazaar. Alfred will take... Wait, not that. A recure potion. Well, we have 10 of them. Recure potion. And Lodi will just attack this thing. Recure potion! Awesome. Up to full. Still this other Baza minion just hanging out. Still kicking. I'm kind of wondering if maybe we can't defeat the Bazaar. Oh, it healed. Maybe we need to take out the Baza minion first. There's plenty of times I've seen battles like that. .106 it gains back at the end of every round. I know we can kill these things, so let's kill them. Wait. Alfred, no. Alfred, attack this. You can't reach that. Then we can focus on this one enemy. Yes! And now we have finishing moves as well. Okay, here we are, finishing move. Chris, heal self. Alfred, attack. Lodi. What am I doing? Alfred, finishing move. Shine flat. And then Lodi. Use a recare potion. Witness the might of my spear. Oh, I remember this. I love that. We just gotta damage it faster than it hits itself or heals itself. Sweet. Alright, at least this thing is slow. We got it. Look at all this XP. Sweet. And we got a guard ring plus one. 31 gold. Should have got more gold, I think. Oof. Yo-Yo says, Lodi. Still asleep. I wonder if he's okay, Chris says. Alfred says, all his hard work is finally hitting him. His hatred toward Galga was what kept him going. An average soldier would have collapsed long ago. He has to rest for a while to fully recover. Morrison says, Magisa has used all her power, too, and is asleep. She used a lot of spells. Let's let her rest. Magisa told me something before she went to sleep. When the parasitic monster that was controlling Galga was defeated, Galga regained himself. He won't attack towns anymore. We'll go back to his sea quietly. Please be assured. Alfred says. We really loaded Magisa with a lot of pressure this time around. Morrison, please stay by her side. Yes, Your Majesty. Thank you for your kindness. Yurio, Chris, thank you for your help. The operation wouldn't have succeeded without the help of Lodi and the both of you. Especially Yurio. Ambush was saved because of your efforts. Really, I wish to express my thanks. You're making me embarrassed, Chris says. Me too. It seems like we're important when you tell us things like that. I don't think so, Chris says. Anyways, I don't think so. How are all the other soldiers? The soldiers who were thrown by Galga luckily landed on the sand, so they were not hurt badly. No one was killed. We were fortunate. The soldier says, excuse me, Your Majesty. What is it? Galga has returned to his home. His strength is immense. He restricted his movement, but he easily went back to the sea. He went back home, Chris says. If Galga was his own self, Alfred says, we probably would have been defeated. Good work. Tell everyone to rest. Yes, sir. So, what are you going to do? Yo-Yo says, oh yeah, we were on a pilgrimage, weren't we? You sometimes disappoint me, Chris says. Are you fully awake? The shrine in Agunis is next, right? Yo-Yo says. Alfred says, oh, if you travel to Ambush by going the southern route, you'll pass Amdera. I thought we were in Ambush. Yo-Yo, Chris, stop by, will you? We'll prepare a big feast. A feast? Yo-Yo says. Yurio, you're drooling. Yurio says, we'll stop by the castle. The Galga incident, which began near Negar Island, is finally solved at the port of Bolt in Ambush, thanks to Yurio and his friends. They decide to accept Alf's invitation, promising to meet up at Castle Amdera and return to their pilgrimage. Their next stop, the Shrine of Fire in Agunis. yet the mystery remains unsolved. Who summoned the parasitic Bezerra, which was feeding on the Galga? The two young pilgrims are still unaware that everything happening around them stems from a single cause. I didn't know that the thing had to be summoned. Chapter 2, Battle of Bolt, End. Now beginning, Chapter 3, Shadow. Alfred says, the area where the Shrine of Agunis stands is called the Serpent Tongue. The large mountain range to the south of Ambush is called the Backbone of the Great Serpent. The shrine is located near where the serpent's head would be. Since this road goes directly to the Shrine of Agunis, you won't get lost. You can leave from the south exit. Leave Lodi up to me. I should be able to take care of him better once I get to Amdera. Oh, so Lodi's not coming. Take care, then. Don't forget to stop by the castle on the way from Agunis. Morrison says, Master Yerio, Master Chris, Magisa entrusted this to me. It's magic ring plus 2. Please take it with you. That is all she can do. We got the magic ring plus 2. See you at the castle Amdera. Wow. Accessories. Boost the power of magic spells to a greater extent. Well, that's obviously for Kristen. Magic ring plus 1. And change it to... What does it make? A magic attack, right? Up to 67. Trying to see what her stat is already. Well, if I change it, 67, 62. Okay, it gives her 5 more. It's pretty sweet. Alright, we're going to talk to everyone in here, then we're going to head out the south exit and continue on our pilgrimage. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you next time, and always seek adventure.